Help me. Help me, help me. Please help me. Help me. Help me. Please, somebody help me. Help me, please, somebody help me. Please, somebody help me.
Help me. Please, somebody help me. Somebody's looking at me. Somebody's watching me. Help me. Please, help me. Help me. Help me. Help me. Help me. Please. Help me. Help me. Somebody's looking at me. Please, help me. Help me. Help me.
Clock
him. Please, somebody help me. Somebody's looking at me. Somebody's watching me. Help me.
Get him out of there.
Help me.
Quick.
Help me. Help me.
Release the subject. I'm the double. All right, Colonel, go.
He's all right, sir. Delusions, I think. He's coming out of it now.
Fine. Did you get all the data recorded?
Yes, sir, every bit of it.
Did you get a timing on him?
484 hours, 36 minutes.
Good. I want to have a look at all the data as soon as it's compiled, and I want to see the reaction shot on him, too.
Yes, sir.
The press, sir.
Oh, yes, sir. On the run, gentlemen, if you don't mind, I want to see Sergeant Ferris.
Do you consider this a success, sir?
Very much so. The man was confined alone in a box for something in the neighborhood of 484 hours. That's roughly equivalent to a trip to the moon, several orbits, and return.
And this was a simulated trip to the moon, is that right, General?
For all intent and purpose, yes.
What about these wires attached to him?
Electrodes. All of his reactions were charted and graphed. Respiration, heart action, blood pressure.
What happened to him toward the end, General, before he pushed that button or whatever it was?
What happened to him is that he cracked. Delusions of some kind, we assume. But let me tell you all something, gentlemen. If any one of you were confined in a box 5 feet square for 2.5 weeks, all by your lonesome, without hearing a human voice other than your own, I'll give you especially good odds that your imagination would run away with you too. Such as his obviously did. Excuse me. Need help?
How do you feel, sir?
So much better, sir. I'm sorry about toward the end.
Sir.
What was it like, Ferris? What did you think you were?
A place I don't want to go again, sir. A town. A town without people, without anybody. What was the matter with me, Doc? Just off my rocker, huh?
Just a kind of a nightmare that your mind manufactured for you. You see, we can feed the stomach with concentrates. We can supply microfilm for reading, recreation, even movies of a sort. We can pump oxygen in and waste material out. But there's one thing we can't simulate. That's a very basic need. Man's hunger for companionship. The barrier of loneliness. That's one thing we haven't licked yet.
Next time it won't be just a box and a hanger, will it?
No, Mike. Next time you'll really be alone.
Thanks.